Welcome to a series of videos on factoring. The goal of this video is to factor a polynomial by factoring out the greatest common factor, also known as the GCF. We will now begin to learn methods for factoring polynomials. Factoring is a technique that is often useful when trying to solve polynomial equations algebraically. We will start our study of factoring by looking for the greatest common factor, or GCF, of a polynomial expression. The GCF is the largest monomial that divides, or is a factor of, each term of the polynomial. To factor an expression means to write an equivalent form that is a product. The first step in factoring is always to look for factors common in every term to identify the largest or greatest common factor. Then we use the distributive property to factor out the GCF and write the polynomial as a product. For example, if we wanted to factor the expression 6x plus 15, we could write 6x as 2 times 3 times x, and we can write 15 as 3 times 5. If we have each term broken down into its prime factors, it's easy to identify which factors they have in common. Here we see both terms have a factor of 3 with no other factors in common. Therefore, the greatest common factor is 3. Therefore, we can factor the 3 out, and the factors not part of the GCF would make up the remaining expression of 2x plus 5. This is considered expanded form, and this is considered factored form. And notice that this is equivalent to 6x plus 15, but it is now written as a product. So the process to find the GCF of a polynomial will be to, number one, write each term in prime factored form. Step two, identify the factors common in all terms. And step three, factor out the GCF. Now, if you know your multiplication tables really well, you may be able to skip this first step, but I will show it for these examples. We can rewrite 2x to the fourth as 2 times 4 factors of x. And 16 in prime factored form would be 4 factors of 2 and 3 factors of x. Now we circle the factors these two terms have in common. They both have a factor of 2, and they both have 3 factors of x. So what we've circled in each term is what they have in common, which gives us the greatest common factor of 2x cubed. So we can rewrite this expression in factored form as 2x cubed times x minus 8. If we want to check this, we can just distribute and see that it does match the original expression. Okay, now the rest of the problems will be essentially the same. It doesn't matter how many terms we have. Write it out in prime factored form. Identify the common factors, and then factor out the GCF. So for this next example, we know that 4 is equal to 2 times 2 times 2 factors of x and 3 factors of y. 20 would be 4 times 5, and 4 is 2 times 2. So we have 2 times 2 times 5, 1 factor of x and 2 factors of y. 12 would be 4 times 3, and 4 again is 2 times 2. So 2 times 2 times 3 times x times y. Now we circle all the factors in common among all three terms. They all have a 2 and another 2 in common. And they all have 1 factor of x and 1 factor of y. So whatever we've circled represents the GCF. So in this case, we'd have 4xy as our GCF. And again, whatever we haven't circled is what's left in our remaining expression. Here we have xy squared plus 5y plus 3. And again, we could easily check this if we wish. Let's go ahead and take a look at two more. Now what we'll notice about these two expressions is the leading coefficient is negative. In general, when the leading coefficient is negative, we factor out a negative greatest common factor. So let's go ahead and start by writing this in prime factored form. So we see each has a factor of 2 and also a factor of x. So even though the greatest common factor is 2x, since the leading coefficient is negative, we will factor out negative 2x. By factoring out a negative 2x, that will change the sign of each term. So the first term would be negative x squared, but since we're factoring out the negative, it will be positive x squared. Here we have 4x, but instead of plus 4x, it'll be minus 4x. And here we have minus 2, but instead it'll be plus 2. We can check our signs, but they will match up. This is the preferred factored form by factoring out a negative greatest common factor. Okay, in the last problem, let's go ahead and write it out in factored form. Now remember, we're looking for terms that are common among all of these terms, and they have nothing in common except for 1 or negative 1. And since the leading coefficient is negative, we will factor out a negative 1, which won't change the factors of the terms, just the signs. So we'd have a positive y cubed plus 2y squared minus y plus 7. And normally we will not leave this negative 1 here. We just rewrite this as negative y cubed plus 2y squared minus y plus 7. I hope you found this video helpful for identifying and factoring out the greatest common factor of a polynomial. Thank you for watching.